In the spirit of the video title, Losing Money and Bad Investments, I want to plow even more money into this beautiful set of irons that I literally can't sell. If you or you know someone that's in the UK and is high class, I'm talking the best of the best, and can restore these back to brand new and I'm happy to pay, I want to give these away at my 50,000 subscriber mark. Because I've tried to sell these, and because it's got to such a low amount now, I physically just can't get rid of them. They are high class performing iron, but no one knows about them, and that's what we're going to talk about in this video. Guys, how are you doing? Welcome back to a brand new video. Simon down here at Stanford Springs Golf Club. Weather is still rather lovely. Last week we talked about how much money I'd made buying and selling secondhand golf clubs. And in that video I said it wasn't all sunshine and rainbows, and there was definitely certain investments, certain clubs that I bought that I've lost money. And we're going to go through my top five today. So basically, you can't make the same mistake. I'm glad I've made those mistakes because I'm now better. And trust me, 2, 3, 4 years time, I'm gonna be even better than I am now. But there are some common mistakes that I have made, and I don't want you guys to make them, whether you're trying to flip clubs yourself or just trying to get a good deal on a driver, irons, whatever it might be. You heard it here right though. This is going to be the number one spot. Beautiful set of irons, and I'm not disappointed that I bought them. I'm glad that Sean, the gentleman that sold them to me, and I'll talk a bit about it later, sold them to me for such a great price. However, why are these not selling? Yet a set of TaylorMade M2 irons that are 5 years old selling for more. Or Ping G-Series irons that are selling for more. And I physically couldn't let these go at the price. I had them up for 270 on an auction. I'm like, what are you doing? So I'm going to be giving these away at 50,000. Yes, I want a professional to restore these, but I've also bought a restoring kit, Carrico kit, quite a lot of money. That's going to be a new series. I'm going to try and restore clubs going forward. But I don't think I can bring myself to do these, not yet anyway, because I'll probably butcher them. Guys, if you wouldn't mind, leave this video a like. A lot of exciting videos to come. Original content, that is the name of the game. Let's get into it. Okay, at number five, we have the golf shafts. Now, if you've been a member of the channel for at least 6 months, you would have known that I spent £960 on 50 to 60 different driver and fairway shafts. Now, the actual investment itself wasn't necessarily a bad thing. It was more of a cash flow. And I guess when it comes to buying and selling stuff, and this is probably more for people that want to obviously try something but then get rid of it, if it's not current, if it's not mainstream and it's not regularly sought after, you're probably gonna be sitting on it for quite a while. And that's exactly the situation that I was in. I spent £960 on shafts when I only had £2,000 in like the business at this point. So we had £2,000. I spent half of it on golf shafts because I thought if I could buy heads, put them together, everything else, obviously I'm making a good deal, which you do, but it's slow. And now I'm at this point, that's great, I've got these shafts, but at the time I could have really done with that money to obviously invest and buy other stuff that I could move on quicker, like drivers that actually have a shaft in them. My advice to you guys when you're buying and selling stuff, or just buying stuff for yourself but potentially you might be moving it on, buy stuff that you know that's popular. We're talking Ping, TaylorMade, Strixon, heads all together, not heads only, not shafts, because you will be sitting on them for a while unless you cut the price down. The other bigger mistake that I made with the shafts is I need to buy an adapter, and adapters cost like £8 to £10. I need to buy a grip, and a decent grip is going to cost you £5. So all of a sudden, £20 a shaft. Some of them were fairway shafts, some of them were ladies flex shafts, but some of them were like light flex shafts, which again aren't as popular and very much sought after. So now all of a sudden my shafts are now costing £35 to £40 to build. You can see where the investment side probably wasn't there. There has been some unbelievable coincidences that I've seen. I've gone, oh fantastic, I've got a £20 head, I've got a £20 shaft, put them together, put a grip on, £100 driver. But it's far and few between, and obviously now I've got somewhat of a bankroll, I can now weather through this. But at the time it was just a silly mistake to obviously have. Number four, we're talking the brand new drivers, the ones that have come out this year. We're talking the Sims, the Speed Zone, the G410s, Callaway Epic Flash from last year, the premium head, and I made a mistake at the very start buying something that was pretty much brand new, going against all my ethos, but I was just excited to have the opportunity to buy one at a good price. Now, I bought a Speedzone driver for £220 in great condition, which, by the way, is a great deal, and if you want to have one in your bag for £220, you'd snap my arm off. However, I didn't want it in the bag, and obviously I wanted to invest it. So I'm not saying don't go and buy a Cobra Speedzone for £220, because that is a good deal. Even the F9s at the moment, the previous model still going for like £200-240 depending on condition. So the Speedzone for that price is a bargain. However, if you're looking to then move it on as a profit, that's where it came down to it. £280-290 was probably like a reasonable like price, let's say, for the condition it was in, but then you take fees out, then I had to insure it, because I literally, at this point, this was like one of my 7th, 8th sales ever, I couldn't afford to lose it, so then I had to insure it, which cost another £25, postage, cash flow, because I needed to move it, again, similar, cash flow is so important with this kind of stuff. So therefore, it was just a bad investment. I spent £220, I think I probably made about 15 quid all in all. So, with that all being said, just be wary about investing or buying really new stuff, especially if you haven't hit it. If you're looking for an F9 Speedzone, why not look at an F8? It's different color, pretty much similar. The shafts just probably aren't as good. But if you're just starting the game, it's gonna more than easily do the job. Number three is non-complete sets. Now, I've bought a couple of non-complete sets throughout this journey, and I actually bought two sets. I actually bought a lovely set of Adams clubs, and I also bought these DCIs as well, and they were both missing a 6-iron. Now, the deal itself was a great deal, and the gentleman that sold it to me was a member of the channel, and at the time, again, very good. But missing a club out of a set, even though it might be a great deal and you might be thinking, oh, fantastic, you're gonna have to get that other iron from somewhere. And people know that you need to get that iron from somewhere, and you're paying over the odds to then match that setup to the point that you might as well just buy a brand new set that you know is gonna be the right length, the right lie angle, similar shafts, grip, everything else. So, biggest advice, don't buy incomplete sets like I did. Make sure that they have the full complete set, and normally if you're looking at a set of irons and you're thinking, oh, should I just buy this quickly before anyone else does, make sure to check the description, make sure all the irons are there, because there's nothing worse than clubs turning up and you're missing one, you check the item description and you can't get a refund or anything else like that, and you're going to be stuck with them just like the other person probably was. So number three, and definitely I'll show you what these iron sets sell for. I think I paid about £150 for these two sets of irons, which I was thinking 70 quid for two sets of irons, good deal. I lost money, but anyway, that is a lesson learned, and obviously something I want to share with you guys. If you were looking at getting a broken down set, just be wary, you might be stuck with it with a long time, or be paying over the odds to get an iron to go in it. Number two, not looking properly. Very similar to number three. At the moment, I look at new listed stuff, I go through, try and see if there's any good deals, is there a buy it now option, and then if there is, perfect. You would have seen my M6 deal that I got a couple of weeks ago, £150 for two M6 woods. That was a fantastic deal, and I was very happy with it. However, again, I've been buying G400 for whatever reason. I wanted to buy G400 woods because, again, they're sought after, they're popular, and I know they're going to move quickly. But I didn't check the photos properly, I didn't check the descriptions properly, and both of them have got quite heavy sky marks and weather marks. Therefore, in a video you will see soon, devalues the clubs a lot. Do take your time, have a look at the photos, have a look at the descriptions, just like I said before, because even though I've paid £90 to £100 for both of these woods now, I think maybe more with delivery, I'd have to sell them at least £130, £120 to make my money even back. Therefore, I'm going to be losing money on both of them. They're both great woods, but not many people like Skymarks. I don't like Skymarks, and it's something, especially when it comes down to condition of golf clubs, that really is dependent on what kind of money you're going to get for them. So, again, lost money on these clubs, but I'm going to get a good video out of them, and I guess, which you'll see, and obviously the number one spot with the Miura irons, I'm kind of about the content, as well as obviously trying to make a bit of money here and there. And at the number one spot, we have the Miura irons. Bought these about 2 months ago from Sean, one of the guys that watches the channel, and I'm very happy with the deal. I didn't want to pay anything less than 450 for the bag, the irons, the wedges, because I know as someone that's been in the scene for 10 years, how expensive these irons are and the work and craftsmanship. He had them blacked out. One of the first Muir sets that had ever been done had to be done in America. I played 9 holes with them. You saw the video. The video did incredibly well. So that's why I'm not in the slightest bit worried or annoyed or not happy with the deal that I did with Sean. £450 for 3 wedges, these, and a bag is a very good deal. But if I wanted to get the monetary value back for these irons, I can't do it. I had them originally up for £600. Again, I was reluctant to sell them because I kind of wanted them back. £500, £400. Obviously, I needed the money to then invest in more clubs at the time. I sold the wedges. The wedges had gone for £180. The bag I'm keeping because it's got numerous amounts of shafts, clubs, everything else in it. And again, I don't think I'm going to get anywhere near the kind of value that I want for it that someone's willing to pay. How many people want a Muir staff bag in their living room, garage, whatever? These were actually on at one point for £270 starting bid. I've seen sets of G30 irons, G10 irons that go for similar amount of money. And they were on for about 12 to 24 hours and I took them down going, what are you doing? Why? I've got enough bank balance now that I can kind of buy in clubs here and there. So in terms of like cash flow, we're a lot better than we were 4 months ago. Why am I trying to give these away? So then it hit me. As I said at the start of this video, I want to get into restoring clubs. As well as buying and selling clubs, I want to restore clubs using Kerakote, which I've done my research is kind of the best way to properly finish out clubs, make them look class. I want to learn how to sandblast, I want to learn how to polish, I want to learn how to regroove, whatever it might be. That is the idea with a future series in the channel. Now, do I trust myself to do it with these? Probably not. I probably want to get some kind of professional to do that. And I think it would be a good story. I'd like the person, whoever I work with, to get these obviously refurbished. I'd like to be able to film the process, obviously what they looked like before, during, techniques, everything else, because there's not much in terms of golf club restoration. We all have a set of irons that are beautiful and a best set of irons we've ever hit if you've been playing the game a long time, but they just look old, tatty. How do you get them back to their former glory? And I've looked on YouTube a lot, and apart from like just getting like paint infills, that's pretty much about it. There's nothing to do with golf club restoration, or very few videos anyway. So as a very much novice golf club restorer, i.e. I've never done one, I'd love to restore a Scotty Cameron, I'd love to restore a set of wedges, whatever it might be, and I think that'd be a cool series. And then at the end of it, hopefully we're somewhere close to 50,000 subscribers by the end of the year. That's kind of the goal I have for these. So at Christmas time, these are gleaming, and one of you guys will then get them. I did sell the set of wedges, by the way. The wedges went for £180. So to break even, I'd have to sell, as it is, I'd have to sell these once you take fees, postage, everything else out. I'd probably have to sell these for about £350. I don't think that's going to happen. So that's why we're doing the giveaway. So guys, there you have it. That is the plan for future series. That's the plan for these set of irons. There's the kind of mistakes I have made over the last 3 to 4 months. I've been quite savvy. Like, I haven't really paid over the odds for much just because I don't want to lose money, for the obvious reasons. But there's definitely been some mistakes, and I've probably been a bit arrogant or naive in certain situations. And hopefully you've taken something away from this video to obviously help in terms of you buying clubs in the future. I'm excited for this. Guys, if you wouldn't mind leaving this video a like, subscribing if you're new. Catch you guys later.